Hello everyone, in this video I will show you how you get attendance record tracker for your employees, which is free and easy to use. First we go to file and click new, and from the search online we type employee attendance and click search. And I would like to remind you, this is work on Office 2016. And as you see, we have one template, click it. You see this is created by Microsoft and it is totally free. And then click create. As you see, we have a calendar for all months and all the days. And we have a drop down list for employees, which we can add new employee or modify this. And if you click any employee, you see the color changes for the days has been taken by this employee. For example, employee number 5, it has many days. And if you scroll down, you see the type of leaves was taken by this employee, the days and the total numbers of the days. This is the general overview for the attendance sheet. Now let's see how you can modify or customize it. First we go to the list of employees. As you see, we have 5 employees. You can delete these or you can add more employees by dragging and drop this corner down. Okay, I will add a new employee, for example John Doe, or Jack Huron. If you go back to the calendar view, you see the employee has been added, and as you notice that there is no days leave taken by this employee as he is a new employee and we didn't add any leave for them. Okay, this is step number one. Add the new employee. You come to this sheet and you drag and drop this corner and you add a new employee. The second step is employee leave tracker. You click on the sheet and as you see, it has all the records for the leaves was taken by these employees. If you want to add more, you come to this corner, drag and drop, and you click on this drop down box and you see your new employee has been added, and you can, for example, the start date for the vacation or the leave. And the second one, the end date, you put the end date. As you see, it is 3 days and you choose the type of the leave, for example, sick leave. When you go back to the calendar view and you choose John Doe, you see we have 5 days, and because 2 of them in Saturday and Sunday, so the total is 3, because these 2 days is already holiday. And as you see, we have 3 days as a sick leave. And let's go back and add more. Let's see, 9. This is another 2 days, and I will add another vacation, for example. You see, you have a different color for different leave. Okay, this is how to use the attendance sheet. Let's see, we want to add more leave type. For example, I want to add annual leave. What you do, the first step, you can copy and paste this. Click copy. You can paste it here. And as you see, I can adjust it and I can type any one leaf. This is the first step. The second step, you go to the leaf types sheet. You click it, and as usual, drag and drop. And I will add any one leaf. And if you go to employee leaf tracker, for example, I will add we have added 2 days as annual leave. If you go back to calendar view and you choose Jack Heron, you see nothing happened and there is no color on his calendar and the annual leave is not being calculated. So we have to adjust it. Click on this. First, I will apply a new color for the annual leave, the red one. Okay, the second, we have to modify the function. As you notice, at the end of the function, you have the leave type and B10. So we go to leave types. The annual leave is B8. So go back to calendar view and change this to B8. So you have to change this accordingly. Click enter. You see you have 2 days as a leave, but on the calendar still not appear. So what we do, because it is conditional formatting, we'll apply the color for the days. What we do, you click anywhere on the calendar and you go to conditional formatting and then go to manage rules. You see you have some rules for other leaves type. So we add a new one. We can easily, without writing any code, without having any information about the functions, we can get one of them, double click, and copy the function. And then click new rule. Then click use a formula to determine. And then paste the formula you already copied. But you have to change the last part of the function to the leaf type. As you remember, it was 8. So you just delete this and put number 8. And then apply the format. Click format. You go to fill and choose the color, which is red. Click OK. Click OK. And apply. And as you notice that we have to copy this range and paste it here. Paste and apply. As you see, now the format has been applied. We have 3 days leave, but because one of them is on Sunday, and Sunday and Saturday is holiday, so the total will be 2 days leave. And if you scroll down, you see 2 days leave and the total days leave is 2. Another thing you can do is for example, in most countries in Middle East, Friday and Saturday is holiday. So if you notice that they are grayed out Saturday and Sunday as they are a holiday. So if you want to make Friday and Saturday as a holiday, we can do that as well. So we go to employee leave tracker, and we will apply to all. So we will start from the first row. Click this. You see network days. There is a new function in Excel 2016, which is same, but with more functionality. You just type dot, you see, NTL. If you press tab, it will auto-complete. And as you see, you can modify, you can delete this comma and write it again. You see, you have a drop-down list and it shows the numbers and days. These numbers, you can, for example, if you put now one, Saturday and Sunday will be holiday. But in Middle East, as I said, Friday and Saturday is holiday. So I will put number 7 and then another comma and enter. So as you see, the change has been applied to all the all the rows. And if you go back to the calendar view, you see that 2 changed to 3, as Sunday, Monday, Tuesday is now the working day, and Friday and Saturday is holiday. And the gray, you see, the Saturday and Sunday is grayed out because they were a holiday. Now it's Friday and Saturday is holiday. So I would like to gray out the Friday and bold the Sunday. For this, this has been done with conditional formatting. I'll click the conditional formatting and click manage rules. So if you scroll down, double click this, you see left 5 character start with S. So what I will do, I will change it to Saturday in order to ignore the Sunday, and click OK, apply. Because we added 2 character, we have to modify something else as well. Scroll down, double click. Because it is 2 character SA, you have to change this one to 2. Click OK, apply. See, the Sunday has been bold and the Saturday grayed out only. And we also need to gray out the Friday to indicate that it is holiday. Same way, you click conditional formatting, manage rules, and what we do, we double click this rule, copy this formula. As I said, you don't need to know about the formula, only slightly change will do the job for you. Click new rule, use formula, and paste. This time we change this to F, and this one, because it is 1 character, we change it to 1, and click format, and this time is font. The font is, I believe, this color. Okay, and if you notice, we have to copy this range and paste it here, apply. Okay, I think we did something wrong because Friday has not been grayed out, so let's do it again. But this has been changed, so just put C, and this one C letter, and click format, and change the color of the font to the one same like the other one. Also, I have to change this to F and this to 1 character. Apply. Okay, as you see, Friday also grayed out, and Saturday grayed out. Okay, another thing I would like to add is adding employees details. For example, we have a list of employee. I can go to this corner and drag it horizontally. In this case, I need let's see, three columns. For example, I will change this column to position, and this one to employee number. For example, employee number one is HR manager, and employee code or number is something, and this is IT manager, and this one is admin assistant. Okay, now we have 1, 2, 3 column. In the calendar view, I would like to add position. Dynamically, when an employee has been changed to from the drop down list, I would like to display the position for that employee. So what I will do, let me make some merge here and change the background to something like this, and the color for the font. Now I would like to, when I change the employee here, display the position in this box. So I will write a simple function equals if error VLOOKUP. We use VLOOKUP. I have a video on VLOOKUP, how to use it. VLOOKUP for what? For this employee, where in table employee, we have a table employees tab, it will autocomplete. In that table, we want column number 2. And we want the exact same as the one chosen from the drop down box. And then you see employee number 3 is admin assistant, and employee number 2 is IT manager, and employee number 1 is HR manager. Another thing I would like to add is employee code. This one also I can merge some cells together. Same way like the position, right, equals if error VLOOKUP for what? For that employee, from where? From employees table. This time I want column number 3 to be returned back in that cell. And I want exact same, close the parentheses. As you see, we have the code for that employee number 1. If you change the employee, you see the number as well change. With the this employee number 4, we didn't add any number and position for that one, so that's why it's not showing up. Also, I would like to add the starting date. Can merge or like this. All right, I believe that's all for now. If you have any question, please drop it in the comment down the video. I will have a look and try to answer you as soon as possible. If you like the video, please like and share in order to other people get advantage from it. Thank you.